Hey, welcome back, class, and let's take a look at the selecting the material activity again. So the activity requires you to kind of make a decision on what material you want to use on your sole. Trace your foot on an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper. You might need two pieces depending on how big your foot is. Trace it, upload it to Google, Onshape, and use that image to create an accurate trace of your sole. So let's go through the directions here. Several items that you need to read. First of all, number one, determine what type of shoe you want to create. Here are some examples. Hiking boots, slippers, sneaker flip-flop, a slipper, or some other kind of shoe. Trace your foot, import that image onto your computer, and then create an Onshape, create a sketch plane, and then place that image onto Onshape inside your sketch and dimension it so you can start your trace. So I know what the directions say, and they aren't 100% specific. I just tried to work this out and it was a little bit strange. So here we go. Sketch. I'm going to name this sketch sole. Sketch plane is the front. Sketch sole. And I want to import an image onto this sketch. So I'm going to go to image. And there it is, insert image. It's also found right here. See it? So the image I want to import, I'm going to choose the import option here at the bottom. It's, I don't want to import all those. It's right here, foot trace. Let's go open. And it's going to upload. When it uploads, it's going to show up right here on this little section. So there it is. Now, what you do is you grab it. And that's what I didn't realize. You just grab it and drop. And that didn't quite work. Let's try it again. Well, let's click on it then. Click on the origin. Oh, there we go. It's it got weird. I wanted to attach it to the origin, so I kind of messed up there. It says draw an image rectangle. So there's my image rectangle. I'm going to modify it, anchor it. So got a little weird there. I had to import it. I click on the sketch plane, and then you get this image rectangle that pops up. Let's try that one more time so it's a little more clear. Let's see. Let's go to the image, insert an image. Let's click on that. And then it says draw an image rectangle. So I'll click here. I'll come out this way. Stop there. Then I'm going to go to my dimension tool. And we know this is going to be 8.5. Okay, and this is going to be by 11. Now that got weird. Not sure why that happened. So let's just go. Undo. Oh, I think I know why that happened. Because it's already scaled properly. So when I went 8.5 here, this is already about 11. See it? So it's that the image rectangle is scaled proportionally, so you can't distort the image, which is great. So we'll let that be. So now that we have this the shoe or the sole, I want to rotate this. So I'm going to go back to, let me just delete this sketch here. Activate the sketch and undo. Oops. Let's close that out. So again, I've got a couple of things here. One of them is incorrect, so I got rid of it. But you'll see it says sketch of a sole. That particular sketch is the wrong one. So let me delete that. That's the one I want. I'm going to rename this really quick. Sketch one sole. Excellent. I want to rotate this. And so let's activate that sketch. Let's go to the transform tool, which is, let's see, there it is. transform. Let's click on the actual object. Maybe I have to left click and highlight the whole thing, I think. There you go. So the transform triad here, there's this angle rotation here. I'm going to choose 30 degrees. And I think that's going to be about right. So let's just left click on the mouse. Perfect. Now what I'll do is I'm going to take that. And I think I can move it now. It's transformable. Perfect. About right there. So I'm going to create a couple of construction lines to anchor it right in the center there. So let's go here. Midpoint. So I chose the point tool. Midpoint. Let's go construction line, LQ on the keyboard. Hover there, click, and click. And let's get out of there again. LQ, do it again. LQ on the keyboard. And double click. There we go. So now I'm going to go my line tool or my point tool. Click on there. I want to make sure that's coincident. And now I can snap it into place here. Coincident tool. Perfect. Let's go I again on the keyboard for coincident and remove it. Now you should be able to rotate this. Let's see. Yeah, see how it rotates? See that? So I'm going to try to anchor it so that it's about right there. And so I need to add a construction line coming across LQ on the horizontal here. And now let's go to the D dimension tool. Click on this construction line and then that one. And that angle is 59.7. Let's just make it an even 60 degrees. And it's anchored and constrained. I like it. Nice. So now I'm going to sketch right here. Use sketch tools to outline the sole of your shoe that will fit your foot. Okay, then extrude it to make it a three-dimensional sole customized to your foot. Perfect. So I'll use the spline tool here, and I'm going to click away. Okay, you'll see it all done in just a bit. Let me refresh my screen. So again, I'm going to use the spline tool to make that happen. So here it is, the spline tool. I zoomed in. And let's, left click. And so the more you left click, the more precise your curve is going to be. It doesn't have to be exact. There's my big toe. You can see it. And you just kind of work it through. So let me pause the video. Well, I'll just play it all the way through. Why not? Let's drag this up. Here, I'm not sure what happened, so I'm going to just kind of truncate right in here. Because my foot doesn't do that. Whatever that happened there, it doesn't. See my toes here, see them? Pinky. It's like a middle toe right here. Perfect. All right, so there's my outline, my foot. And now we're gonna extrude that by using the extrude tool. And I'm gonna extrude that anywhere from a half an inch to an inch and a half as a sole. I'm gonna choose a half an inch for now. So again, anywhere between half an inch and an inch and a half. Looks great. And we'll accept it. And there is my sole of my foot. Looks pretty cool. So that is step one in creating a sole for your foot. That's activity 1 through 10 on section 1.1.3. Good luck. Next video is on its way. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.